Introductory session on Agile methodology and prototyping from YesM Systems.
Now what we are going to do is we are going to look at what is called an agile process where steps can happen in parallel. Okay. Parallelly, requirements, design, development and testing can all happen in parallel. So that is what is going to be the essence of next 20-25 minutes of the conversation. So that is going to be agile. So let's look at that method. Okay. So the difference between agile and waterfall is highlighted here. So in waterfall method, if you look at it, as I just described a couple of minutes ago, it's serial like a relay race. Okay, it's serial like a relay race. You try to deliver as many functions as possible in one release, okay, or one implementation. That is like, you know, maybe 50 requirements are to be completed by December 31st. You try to deliver as many requirements as possible, and in the most cases, all the requirements by December 31st. Okay, that's what happens in waterfall. Lots of documentation is involved. And in agile, team members sitting in the same area is not, unlike agile, team members sitting in the same area is not required. So the four, you know, some of the, there are more things probably. But some of the major points are waterfall is serial in nature. Like I explained, feasibility study, requirements, design, development, testing, and implementation. Then you try to deliver as many requirements as possible. Lots of documentation. And team members sitting in the same area is not required. But agile is more different. Agile is parallel, as I explained. Agile is more parallel in nature, like I explained. In, unlike serial, it is more parallel. Parallel like a rugby game. Okay, iterations. Agile concepts have a concept of iteration. That is, goal is to deliver. The requirements are delivered in iterations. First iteration may be 15 requirements. Next 20 requirements are delivered by October 31st, and the last iteration December 31st, you deliver the remaining requirements. Less importance to documentation. Whereas here it's more documentation, here it's less documentation. Okay. More documentation, less documentation. Here agile members sitting in the same area is not required. Here team members sitting in the same area is required because agile promotes face-to-face communication over return documents. Okay. These are the some other differences. Let me give you more information. You have this slide also, Scrum. Look under Scrum. So what we are studying now is the agile method. Generally about what is agile. Okay. Generally about what is agile. So this is a very important one because Mayuk will be teaching you regarding Scrum. Mayuk will talk about Scrum. Okay. So you are learning about agile. General agile. Agile has got. We will also talk. I'll later on towards middle of June. I'll be also talking about RUP. You learn about Scrum and RUP, but Scrum and RUP are interconnected in that they are part of agile method. Okay, that's something that I wanted to share with you. Going back, okay, so these are the some of the differences. Okay, so people who are not exposed to relay race, so this is how it looks like. So let me show you a relay race versus a rugby game. So here, look at this image. Like a waterfall, you know, requirement phase, then, you know, if this fellow gives a baton to the next person, the next person can run, okay? Right? So that's what relay race is. You know, relay race is like a, you know, waterfall, right? Requirement is done, then design takes over. Design is done, then development takes over. Whereas in the rugby game, you know, or a soccer game, or American football, so it's all happening in parallel, okay? So it is not like serial in nature, okay? So if you look at rugby images, look at here, everybody is trying to move together, right? So look at all these images. So if you look at it, you know, the teams, you know, entire or soccer, you might have seen a soccer games, right? Teams are trying to move in parallel. Okay. So that is the difference between a relay race and a rugby game. Okay. So the same thing is applicable for the waterfall and agile. One is a relay race, another one is a rugby game. So you understand the concept of iteration. Iteration means, you know, layman's term is installment. You do the entire thing in installment. Here it is just one payment, you know, payment at once. Here you are paying it in installments. Okay, let me take a few questions here. Okay. Yeah, agile method is also user requirements play a role. This agile method also needs to be, you need to write requirements and all that. Yes, maybe with less details, less documentation. Another very important concept I'm going to introduce now is the concept of priority. Okay, whether it is waterfall or agile, priority, the concept of priority plays a very important role. Priority means, you know, which requirements will have to be addressed first and which ones to be addressed later. That is, higher priority requirements are completed first, lower priority are completed later. In any product manufacturing process, you know, it's all done by based on priority. So even when you travel and want to visit places, you know, so like Orlando, you are going to Orlando, Florida, you know, you have your own priority. There are six places to see. Some places you want to see first, lower priority you want to see towards the on the last day or towards the end, so that it is not, you know, if you cannot see, that's fine, right? If you want to, any time you manufacture a product, higher priority items are addressed first. So if Delta's website will have to be built, there booking tickets is the highest priority, right? Why booking tickets is important? Because, you know, you can have all the check-in, check-out, all that you can have, but if people cannot book tickets, there is no revenue. Okay, there is no revenue. If there is no revenue, company cannot be run. So, two high priority requirements for Delta Airlines would be, one is booking tickets, other one would be payment solution. Okay. Two important components of an airline system. So that's what priority means. Priority means to run a business, what do I need now? Okay. All right, any questions so far? I will show you some example, how agile iterations are finalized, who decides it, which method is popular, all that I will address a little later, okay? Okay. So BA has very little or no say in deciding which method to use. It's all decided at the company, company's technology, or senior technology team. They may say, you know, senior technology team and the business, meaning at the VP level, director level, or if it is a small company, CTO level. At that level, they will decide, okay, we don't need waterfall for this, we need to go with agile. Which method is popular? Waterfall is popular too. Agile is also very popular. Okay, waterfall has been in use for a long time. Agile is more like 10 to 15, 20 years. Okay, all right. So now let's look at a small example on how the things work in parallel and all that, you know, we'll see. So let's look at a small example, okay? So let's take a Yago application, right? Yago application that we just looked at, waterfall method. You know, the components or modules consist of sign up. Sign in means log into the system, sign up a new user, inbox, outbox, send and receive email, draft emails, video, audio, so many features are there. So you have 6 months to do this project. 6 months for the, let's say 6 months. So in the first 6 months, you know, let's say, you know, we have to complete all this. First they will do feasibility study, requirements, design, development, testing, deployment, completed in 6 months or X number of months. How it is implemented in Agile? In Agile, it is divided, you know, the whole entire set of features are divided into one or more iterations. In the first iteration, higher priority items are selected. For Yahoo Mail, which one would be of higher priority? People's ability to sign in, you know, log in and sign up a new account. Inbox, outbox, compose an email, send and receive an email. At a minimum, we should have it. Let's say this is 1995. At a minimum, we need this function so that users can, customers can operate or use a new web-based email. Lower priority items would be video, audio, even attachments can be done later, address book maybe later, reminders, draft, all that can be, you know, done later. So understand the, you know, higher priority versus lower priority. So in Agile, higher priority items are addressed at the spot of iteration 1, lower priority items are pushed to iteration 2. In waterfall also priority plays an important role, but your goal is to deliver all of them together, overall goal. Okay. So with this example, let's see, you know, so how this is done in parallel. You need to pay careful attention, otherwise you will not understand. Okay. So in summary, what happens is, once again, so in a week one, you know, that is, I call it as one unit of time. It could be few hours or 2 days. The requirement team works on sign-in module. And in after one unit of time, it is moved to the design team. Then sign-up is taken during the second unit of time, right? So during third unit of time, sign-in is moved to development. And design team is doing sign-up. And the common team is busy with inbox. So similarly in fourth week, if you look at it, fourth week, right, you know, sign in goes to testing, sign up is in development, inbox is in design, outbox is in requirement. Once sign in is you know, completed, it goes into sort of a wait mode and waits for other modules to arrive. Modules means you know, a unique part of a, you know, like inbox is a module, outbox is a module. Right, sign in is a module, sign out is a module, like that. Right, so it goes into wait mode. In QA testing, if there are any problems, there is nothing wrong. You know, the sign in can travel back and come back to testing and then come back to the wait mode. After all the modules are arrived, so it's thoroughly tested, integration testing type of testing is done. Integration is a type of testing. Then software is ready for implementation. So similarly, iteration 2 is carried out, and iteration 3, and so on. Okay. Any question so far? Sandhya, you have a question?
Yes. My question was: did you say that they are all tested at the same time?
They have to be tested. I know. Well, individually, they are tested. Individually, they have to be tested. Then they all have to be tested together as well. Do we have less time to complete a project with Agile method? You know, yeah, it is sort of very fast-paced environment. Yeah, I mean, there are also fewer things are done, you know, so it is not like waterfall, you do all of it together. You are doing, trying to do fewer requirements at this, at a time, but there is also, it's a fast-paced environment, okay? Yeah, it's not like that, Ritu. In some cases, you know, requirements depend on each other. It doesn't mean that requirements don't depend on each other. Requirements, some other requirements, you know, just like the regular system only, you know, requirements may depend on each other, but still they can be individually tested. It is possible that they can be through scripting and, you know, artificially creating data. They can always test the module individually, then together. Yeah, this one, go ahead.
Yes, so from what I understand, each module does its part, and then they wait at a junction for all the modules to complete in their iteration. It's taken to the stakeholders for approval, and then you do integration testing and then implement the software, right?
No, you don't add. I never talked about stakeholders approval,
no, that's
all that. Yeah,
yeah, but I'm just wondering, what would the term be to who? Somebody has to approve the whole thing, right? So who would that be?
Because, you know, the integration testing will have to be completed.
Yes,
so
that's what I'm saying.
Testing is
okay.
Done. Once that is done, right, integration testing also will have to be done. Okay,
yes.
Then, you
okay.
know, it makes sense to say that, okay, testing is completed and, you know, so Agile may not even have an approval. Okay,
oh,
so
okay.
There is less documentation. Some companies may have approval, some companies may say, hey, it's done, you know, take it forward. But more majority
oh,
of larger companies have some kind of approval process saying that, okay, software is ready to go. Okay, let's discuss some more about this. Okay, so in the slide, the slides that I have sent you, you will find the Agile slides after the waterfall slides. So many of the things that I talked about, you will see it here. Okay, it promotes the iterative approach. Software developed during one unit of time is referred to as an iteration, right, which may last from 1 to several weeks. Okay, each iteration is an, each iteration includes everything, so feasibility study, requirements, design, coding, testing, all of it will include. Okay, another important point for knowledge purposes, an iteration may not add enough functionality to warrant the release of the product to the market, but the goal is to have an available release without any bugs at the end of each iteration. Just because an iteration is completed doesn't mean that you have to release the product to the customer. In Agile, the overall goal is to, make sure your release is available without any bugs. It depends on the goal of the iteration. Some iterations may be released, some iteration they might have to wait for the first 2 iterations or 3 iterations to complete before releasing the product to the customer. So, but the goal here is, to make sure that, an iteration, goal here is to have an iteration or a release without any bugs, right? So that is also one of the Agile iteration goals. At the end of each iteration, Agile will re-evaluate project priorities. So in Agile, there may be 500 things to do. In the first iterations, we may have done only 50. So now you need to go back, look at the remaining 450 requirements, and in the meantime, 20 new requirements may be added. Okay. So then, you have to reprioritize. Meaning, what I mean here is, So January 1, the Agile iteration was started with 500 requirements. It was prioritized and they started off with 50 requirements. By Feb 15th, right, so remaining is 50 requirements are knocked off, you have 450 left. By February 15th, you have 450. But between this time period, another 20 requirements might have been added. So you have now 470 to deal with. So what do you do on February 15th when you want to start the iteration 2? You look at all the 470 requirements and probably select another X number of requirements for iteration 2 based on the priority. Okay? So just that is what, reprioritizing means. So yeah, Rizwan, I have already sent all the slides. Okay? All right. Another question is the time period. Time frame may differ from company to company. The one unit of time could be few weeks to, couple of months. It depends. Agile iterations time period is normally very short. Unlike a waterfall, which may run into months and sometimes even years. So team members sitting in the same area. Sometimes called bullpen. If you guys had watched baseball game, they have what is called a bullpen. Okay, bullpen. So in fact, even if you watch T20 sort of, they also have a bullpen. Even soccer World Cup games, I have seen the bullpen. Because team members are sitting in the same area, whereas in waterfall type of method, it's not required. So Agile method is all about face-to-face. Team members are sitting in the same area, which encourages face-to-face communication, which in turn is higher productivity. Okay, Agile is very important from a job perspective. It's very important. Remember that. Okay, so team includes typically programmers, QA, business analyst, and all that. It is no different. Okay, and interaction designers, technical writers, and so on. So it's all it may a little bit differ from company to company, but most of it is the same. Typical roles are involved. So one of the criticisms of Agile method is less documentation. All right, at this point, any questions? Okay, so these are all some of the frequently asked questions, Agile or waterfall, which method I should use? Okay, it depends on the size of the project. I don't have a proper answer, answer for this. In a large project, waterfall, I've seen waterfall being used. In a large projects, Agile can be used. Smaller projects, waterfall is probably better. Less of, even Agile can be used, Meaning about 6 months project, 8 months project, Agile can be probably used. but maintenance project. Maintenance project is when a product is upgraded, right? Product webinar goes through an upgrade process. 3 months worth of upgrade. You know, they may not use Agile. They, for them, probably waterfall is more suitable. So when a product is developed for the first time, let's say 2 man years, involving let's say 3 people, they may use Agile. I'm just saying, you know, 3 people, 2 man years, 6 months, right? Or let's say make it 8 years, 8 man years, okay, enough people to complete it in let's say 12 months, and that means they do it roughly with 8 people. So they may do it in 4 iterations, right? Do it in 4 iterations. So after the first round of product is developed, now it's up and running, so 3 months worth of some maintenance upgrades will have to be done. At that point of time, they may use waterfall. So they started with Agile, then they can move to waterfall. Okay, so that is also possible. There's nothing wrong with that. So which company would use which method? You know, it all depends on the work culture, the politics, and all that. I don't know if there is a good answer for this. In smaller company, normally senior management will decide which process to use. So in a larger company, middle to upper management might decide. It also depends on the work culture. You know, larger company, established company, been there for so many years, there may be resistance to switch over from waterfall to Agile. So in some companies, like AT&T, you would find combination. In some groups, waterfall will be used. Some groups, Agile will be used. Some groups, some other process might be used. Many companies are now using it. So you need a good knowledge of Agile and Scrum. Okay. So the reason why I wanted to do this topic today is Mayuk will teach you guys Scrum. You already have the slides. So just make sure that when you go to Scrum, you understand. You know, so you'll see some of the Agile concepts. It's within the Agile framework. So you'll see the concept of iteration, right? You'll see, iterations. You'll see how team members sitting in the same area, all that, you know. So you'll see all these concepts in Scrum. Okay. All right. So now what we'll do is we'll move on to prototyping. Originally, when I started teaching BA, I had only 4 bullet points for teaching prototyping. I haven't updated this. But as students ask more and more questions, okay, the prototyping, it's become a very large presentation. So this is one of my favorite topics. But before going into prototyping, one thing I wanted to share with you is we looked at waterfall. We just looked at Agile today. Later on, you'll see Scrum and RUP. Later on, you'll see JAD also. Today, we'll look at prototyping. Before moving on to other topics, why you are studying all these topics from knowledge perspective? Concepts are applied in other methodologies like RUP and Scrum, and role of a BA slightly changes with each process. So you need it from knowledge, good perspective, which will give you a good foundation, and then in order to understand RUP and Agile Scrum better, you need knowledge of JAD, RAD, Spiral, and all that. Okay. All right, so let's go into prototyping. Okay, prototyping, once again, I have looked at it purely from a product perspective. Okay, I did not look at it as an IT thing. I didn't, okay, so just purely from a product perspective. So you take a minute and read read from the top. Definition of a prototype of a product. What is a prototype? So take it from there and just take a minute and read it. So you have to think of it from a product perspective. You have to put yourself in the shoes of, let's say you are an individual who has a great idea and you are looking for funds. So that's where, that's how the discussion needs to start. Okay? So you are an individual who has a great idea and, you're looking for funds. Let's say, you want to develop an online auction website. See, but in any type of product, new product development, risks are involved. risk is involved, money is involved. So when risk and money are involved, what do you want to do? You want to minimize, you know, you are trying to minimize your risk, and you are also trying to, you know, be very careful with your investment. Okay, very careful with your investment. You will not just like that throw money, or the investor would not throw money, right? So you know, your role once again is, you know, you want to develop a product, new online auction website. So you are looking for investment. So initially you have probably had $100,000. You invested some money, part of it, and developed a demo version of a product. Why you would develop a demo version of a product? Let's say you go to investor. Nandu, do you think I'm going to give money? Let's say you come and talk to me, no paperwork, nothing. We sit across from each other, have a cup of coffee at Starbucks, and you're saying, hey, I have a great idea to develop this website, and I have $50,000, and I'm looking for $1 million investment. So should I give you the money? Okay. So based on what I would give you money, even if I have $1 billion, I'm not going to give you that money. Okay, you need to show at least something to show that the product is, that idea, at least you have developed 10% of the product and then showing it to me, demonstrating it to me. You need to show a business plan. Without any paperwork, I won't give it to you. Will you give money if I just like that come and say, hey, you have $1 billion, give me a couple of $1 million, I have a great idea. Just orally I'm telling you. No, you won't do that, right? So you want some proof. Okay, the other example I use is the flying car. So suppose I say, you know, you come and tell me that, Nandu, I have a great idea, this car is going to fly, give me some money. I would say, yes, I would give you money, show me at least that your car, your idea, you know, car can fly 500 meters. Prove it to me. Then I would give you some money. So it is all about risk and protecting the risk and protecting your investment. So if you want to approach me with you are looking for investment, and suppose you want to approach me, so what I am looking for is, right, what I am looking for is, okay, a good business plan. Business plan is, what is your plan for the business? Plan should include product details, financials, timeline, marketing plan, competitive study, so on, many things. You can go to Google and search for the business plan template. You know, it will list you all the things that are needed. Then you come and demo the software to me. Software may not have everything, just 20% or 15%, develop it and come and show it to me. Your flying car, this is software. Similarly, flying car, you don't have to, you know, show the entire, develop the entire product and show it to me. That is not needed. So you show me, like, you know, it can fly at 500 meters. Okay, so you're looking for, $2 million. So, you know, if I'm convinced about number one and two, should I give all the money or some money? Right? So $2 million is the total investment that is needed. So what I would do is, I would say, okay, I'm going to give you 25% now and remaining later. So prototyping to begin with, it's all about, protecting somebody's investment, minimizing the risk. So everybody is acting so that, you know, they are trying to minimize their, risk. Even if you have, $2 million, so still you might want to protect your investment. You know, even you would say, okay, let me invest like only 250K and see if the idea is working or not. Then you will, release the next 250K. Okay, so whether you are an investor or you're looking for investment, you would minimize your risk by developing prototype version of the product and then make sure product is working. So what happens is, after the first, I give you initially 250K, okay? So this is Nandu, I'm giving you 250K. You showed me a prototype. Now after 3 months, you come back and say, hey, Nandu, look at here. We have made progress. Now 40% is completed. Can you help us with more funding? So I'll review your product. make sure it is in the right direction. Okay, then I will give you more funding. Okay, prototype is nothing but a sample version of the product, a sample or a model. If you are looking for a new home, what do? You go to your subdivision or wherever, you know, look for a sample home, model home. See if it is, so you are happy with that. Then, you know, you probably will be, you know, buying a new home, right, after that. Okay. Question so far. Yeah, Ritu, there is no defined term for all these things, you know, so man years could agile or waterfall, it could vary from a few months to multiple years. So there is no defined term for all this process. Okay. So coming back to prototyping, any questions? So let's expand on this, okay? Let's expand on this. Look at how Apple phone was probably developed. You know, this is just my thought, okay? One second, Shruti has a question. Yeah, go ahead, Shruti.
Yeah, I just want to know how different a BA role is in prototyping.
Yeah, so we'll wait, you know, just wait for a couple of minutes, we'll see. I'm just talking about
all it.
Right. Okay. All right. So let's look at prototyping of iPhone. You know, probably Apple company started this project X number of years ago, 5, 6, 7 years ago. Okay. So immediately they are not like in 1 month they are going to develop and release the product. Probably a team was assigned to develop the product. They will develop it and test it. So initially probably the management will say, hey, I'm going to give you 6 months. Go ahead and develop the product. Come and show us the first prototype. Okay, and here is your $2 million. You are going to invest it, come and show. So initial prototype may be few things. When you touch the screen should say welcome, you know, you should be able to page up and page down, and few other things. Then the team will come and demonstrate the product to the stakeholders of the company, and the stakeholders are happy, and they will say, okay, now let's do the next version of the prototype, second version of the prototype, here is the next $1 million. Go ahead and develop it, bring it back. So prototyping or no prototyping, it's a part of a, you are developing a product. When you are developing a product, BA's role is to define requirements. But before defining requirements, as far as prototype is concerned, you have to understand the concept and purpose of the prototype. Okay. Why you have to understand? Because, you know, you are only developing part of the product. Okay, just part of the product, and you are focusing on high priority requirements for the product. Why high priority requirements? Because you have to show important functions to a customer. Imagine you are coming to me looking for funds for a flying car. I mean, the car doesn't even fly. Do you think I'm going to give you money? You know, the first prototype should include the ability to fly. Car should have ability to fly at least a few hundred meters. Right? So that is what will impress you. Impress me as an investor. You know, if you come and show a regular car, I would say, you know, no. Okay, you can show a powerful engine, all that, you know, but you have to come and show me a car with a prototype wings, and you know, it should take off, fly for some distance and then come down. Then, you know, I can buy into your idea. Until that time, I'm not going to give you any money. So from an IT perspective, if it is an online auction or you know, any new solution that you are trying to come up with, you need to show it to me, some impressive version of the product, something that is going to catch my attention, right? So those are all high priority requirements. You know, you should develop that, you know, including developing mock-up screen. Mock-up screen is the first, your first homework was developing a mock-up screen. I gave you an assignment to develop a mock-up screen. That is a mock-up screen. Something, sometimes, remember, it is also called, what is that mock-up screen is called? Firmware? I think they have a new term for it. Firmware or something like that. So let me check on that. One, there are four models. Okay. Internal users, external users, startup investor model, and consulting model. So what I think is, so continuing where we left off. Okay. So earlier, if you look at it, we are going to discuss prototyping under four models. The first one is internal users. Okay, from last Thursday's discussion, we you should remember who is an internal user. Internal user is one for whom the product, you know, the product is developed and used internally within the company, right? That's where internal users play a role. For example, Bank of America teller software is a very good example wherein the software is used only for internal use. Okay. So we'll come there, you know. So first let's look at, you know, startup investor model. That's where we discussed about antique option. So antique option is, you know, your new product is going to be developed. So what you do is you first have to develop a prototype version of the product. Then you go to an investor with a business plan, prototype and a business plan, looking for funds. Okay. So external users. What about external users? In the case of external users, let's say you work for a company like, eBay or Webinar. Okay. So initially you will develop the prototype. Okay. Even the Apple iPhone example is very similar. Okay. Initially you develop the prototype. Okay. So then stakeholders will review the product. Right. And then the second prototype will be developed. So for example, Apple iPhone, to develop the first prototype, stakeholders or senior business people will review the prototype and then give time and money for the second prototype. So until, let's say, X number of prototypes are developed, okay, so, you know, it will be all verified and approved. Then, you know, multiple, finally the product is fine-tuned and released. Now they call it as a beta version of the product. Beta version of the product. Multiple prototypes lead to beta version of the product. Okay. So if you go and look on the web, there are, you know, many prototype products. Even, you know, here I can show it to you on the next page. So Google used to have Google used to have something called Google Labs. Okay, so where they would develop, different products and post it for customer review and feedback, like TouchShield. So they are looking for, so they posted this, they kind of posted this product within the labs, and then, you know, wanted customers to review and give a feedback. So here is the feedback rating. Okay, 5-star is given, about 192 different people might have given a feedback. Based on the feedback, they will further improve the product. Okay, based on the feedback, they will further improve the product. Okay, so let's see the questions now. Yeah, Rizwana, go ahead with your question.
So when you just gave an example, that beta version, are they using it to test the product?
Correct. The purpose of beta version is just to use it. Use it for as if it is a live product. Then, you know, it's sort of testing too. So then, give a feedback to the customer. Feedback to the owner of the product. So you don't want to release the entire product. You know, if the entire product without proper user testing, if you release it and then bad feedback, customers don't like it, you know, there is a huge risk involved. Not only the product is going to fail, investment, your company name, brand name, everything takes a hit. Mm-hmm. So many companies, do this beta release.
Beta.
So if you go and look for Yahoo Messenger, there will be a beta version. The huge company like Microsoft, they will be releasing a beta version of Windows 8. They will release it to only their business partners, maybe 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 companies. Okay. The purpose of beta version is just to let a few people, fewer people, test it and give a feedback. Based on the feedback, further improvement will be made. And the product will be released. So this is once again minimizing the risk. What happens, you know, if you just release the product without proper user testing and product fails? Like I said, brand name takes a hit. Your investment takes a hit. Okay, right? Bad name for the company and all the, you know, product is failing. You know, so many risks are involved. In order to minimize the risk, beta approach is taken. So that's what happened when the product is external in nature. That's why I said several prototypes lead to beta version of a product. Beta version is released and then customer will test it, use it and give a feedback. Based on the feedback, product is upgraded product is upgraded and final Windows 8 will be launched. Sandhya, you have a question? Go ahead, please.
When we say that multiple prototypes lead to a data version, how does it work? What do we mean by multiple prototypes? Are there too many people working?
No. You know, see, prototype, most cases, prototype, you know, when a prototype is developed, like for example, flying car, you know, only like in the first prototype, only car will fly at 500 meters. Then, you know, then other, you know, then maybe 1,000 meters. Then later on, maybe 2,000 meters. In the meantime, other parts of the car are developed too. Four prototypes are developed. Now, car is flying at, let's say, 3,000 meters or, you know, or 3,000 feet, whatever. Right?
Okay.
Then this version of it's almost the product is 90% ready. Four multiple prototypes, then, you know, the beta version of the product is released. A few customers, few pilots are going to test it. And they are going to give a feedback. Let's say 100 people test it. And they give a feedback. Based on the feedback, product is fine-tuned or upgraded and final version of the car is released. Understand?
Yes. There could be reasons where they want to revoke the product too. I mean, they do
Come again?
Could there be a situation where they do not want the product depending upon the feedback and the...
Yeah, the that is also possible. Okay, that is also possible. You know, if they think that you know, for some reason product is not working the way they expected, or there is already competition. You know, by the time we decided to release this product, already 2-3 competitors are already have released the product. Right? Or lack of investment to you know, for further manufacture and release, you know, in mass manufacturing and releasing the product. Product is successful, but you don't have enough funds or support, economy is not supporting the, you know, further manufacturing and releasing the product. So many reasons could be there not to launch the product.
That's right.
Yeah? Go ahead.
Thank you. My question here would be if they've already worked on 90% of the project and, you know, a situation comes up where they could not go further, the idea of the product being prototype is like, you know, it's not really useful.
Maybe no, it is useful that. Because, you know, imagine without a prototype, if you had blindly gone ahead with the idea, mass manufactured, right, without, you know, having customers, you went ahead and developed the entire product, even it may be a website, it may be a new website, without customer feedback, without any proper sample of prototype approach, you went ahead, developed the product, invested so much money, time, marketing, advertisement, all that you did, and finally the product fails. Imagine what will happen to the name. If you are a huge company, what will happen to your name? Instead, if you take a conservative approach, you know, for developing a prototype, a beta approach, getting customer feedback, at the time of the feedback, it's not good, there are no customers, you are not likely to get business, then you are on a low profile, you just, you know, dump the product. Many top companies have done that. Okay. Even if you look at it, Google Labs, in the case of Google, was not very successful. So they abandoned the entire website. The entire Google Labs idea was abandoned.
All right.
Okay. Okay. Prototyping need not be associated with every product development. It is an approach that is available for you to utilize. Some companies may do it. Some companies may not do it.
Okay. Thank you.
Sure. Yeah, Raji, go ahead.
Can you explain the internal users? I think I missed it.
Yeah, now it's kind of very difficult. Go and watch the video. Okay. But anyway, internal user is a product that is developed for users within the same company. Right? External users is a product that is developed for users who are outside the company. Like webinar is an you know, extra for external user. If you walk into a bank, the Bank of America teller software is an internal internal software only, internal use only. Okay. So here is an example. I have given this example on Google Labs. You can go on, you know, these are all beta versions of the product that was released. Okay. So now, you know, internal users. Right? So as a BA, you work for a company like AT&T or Bank of America, wants to develop a product. Could be a teller software or billing software. Okay. Prototype, another example, prototyping of a marketing tool is developed for sales, marketing and customer service. Okay. prototyping is demonstrated. You know, you show the product to the stakeholders and users, and then they will give you feedback. So the product is in the right direction, product development would get more funding, and the product is developed and launched. Okay, so it's the same concept, you know. So suppose a new billing solution will have to be developed, so the business analyst will work with the rest of the team to develop a prototype, show a demo version of the product to the users. Then if users think that it is in the right direction, then, you know, more time and money will be given. Right. Consulting model, you know, so let's say consulting company A, you know, is has a complex problem for which it is looking for a solution. So company A approaches company B to develop a solution. Okay, it's a $30 million project or $8 million project, doesn't matter, you know. So in this case, for company A, in order to protect their investment, they can ask company B to take a prototype approach. Okay, show it 20% of the product. Let's look at it. Let's make sure it's in the right direction. Then, you know, we'll move forward with the rest of the product. Okay, so prototyping is, you do the requirement, design, development, testing. So maybe first round is 20% of the product. And the product is analyzed. If it is in the right direction, then, you know, next version of the product is developed. Okay. So in summary, you know, so to develop a prototype, is it part of a BA's job? Yeah. BA is part of a team that would develop prototype. Your job is to, define requirements, but, you know, which requirements you define first? All high priority requirements. That's what I have described here. BA's job, whether internal or external or consulting model, right, any model, BA is part of a team that would develop a prototype. Your job is to gather and define requirements. Okay? So still, you know, as discussed in the previous class, still SME and the user and business will be involved in defining key requirements for the product. So they will be able to help you identify key requirements for the product. Even technology team plays a role to come up with key requirements or high priority requirements for the product. Okay. The key requirements or high priority requirements are the ones that will help you address the feasibility of the product or if the product is working as desired or not. So in conclusion, prototyping is a concept that you must know. By using a prototype or framework, investment and investors are protected, right? Imagine you don't want to invest all the money, you know, you don't want to give all the money to an idea, you know, so you want to give it in installments, or as the product makes a progress, as you can see the progress, you can give more and more money. That way you protect the investment. Otherwise, if you give all the investment at the same time, you know, product doesn't come through, you lose all of it at once. Also, you get to test an idea or a concept. So through prototyping, you are also saving money and time. And risk is mitigated, risk is minimized. Okay. So I just kind of summarized whatever we learned before. Okay. So it is a wonderful concept, right? You can use this concept in any product development. Okay, BA's role is to work with the rest of the team. BA's role is to define high priority requirements and work with the rest of the team to develop the prototype. Okay, overall, from a product perspective, time is saved, dollar is potentially saved, risk is mitigated, and also the purpose of a prototype is to test an idea.